The next one, multiplication and division. Multiplication and division. Now observe, this is an example for multiplication of significant digits or significant numbers. Here we are taking 2.5 into 1.25. 2.5 into 1.25. After multiplying these two, you get 3.125. 125. Now observe here, in the given multiples, given numbers, means given significant numbers, here 2.5 containing only one digit after the decimal. Therefore, the result after multiplying these two numbers, you get 3.125, is containing three digits after decimal. Therefore, it can be written like the number that containing lowest digits, like 3.1. So similarly, here after multiplying these two numbers, you get 7.424. Here 3.2 containing only one digit after 3. Therefore, this can also be written like 7.4. So very easy one. Then next one, similarly coming to division. Division. In this division case, we are taking 2.00 and divide by 1. That is 1.0. After dividing this one, you get 2.00. Like that, you get this number. But here observe, there is only one digit in this number. Hence, it can be written like 2.0. Similarly, 6.02 is divided by 2.0. 2.0, you get 3.10. Right? A 3.01. Now, after dividing, after this number, you can make like 0.05. Okay, this one, 0.05 number. After dividing this one, now here there is 2.0, one number after the 0, therefore this can be written like 3.0. So, this is the addition, subtraction, and multiplication of significant figure. After knowing these mathematical operations, we are going to solve some numericals, means some problems. Now take problems. The first problem is, now observe the first problem. The first problem is a piece of metal. A piece of metal in 3 inches. A piece of metal has 3 inch length. 3 inch length, that is long. In 3 inch long, what is the its length in centimeter? You know SI units. Here we are converting 3 inches into how many centimeters? Centimeter. So now observe here, to solve this one, we know that 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeter. Not 5.4, 3.45 centimeter. 1 inch is equal to 3.45 centimeter. So we know that we have to know 1 inch is equal to 2.45 centimeter. Now to calculate 3 inches in centimeter, we know that 1 inch is equal to 2.45 centimeter. Therefore, for 3 inches, how many centimeter? That is, for 3 inch, therefore 3 inch is equal to how many centimeters? I have to calculate like that. Now do cross multiplication. So cross multiplication is nothing but like that. Like that. That is, question mark is equal to, that is equal to, do cross multiplication, 3 into, that is 3 inch divided by into 2.45 centimeter whole divided by 3 inch into 2.45 centimeter divided by 1 inch. 1 inch. So how much you get? The inches get cancelled. 3 into 2.45. How much you get? 3 into 2.45. You get. After multiplying, you get 7.62 cm. So after multiply these two, get 7.62 cm. Multiply with 7.62 cm. Here, sorry, 1 inch is equal to 5.2 cm. 5.2 cm. Therefore, multiply get 7.62. Like that, we are calculating. So observe, we know that 1 inch is equal to 2.54 cm, therefore 3 inch is equal to how much? That is question mark into 3 into 2.54 cm divided by 1 inch, that is equal to 7.62 cm. So this is 7.62 cm, therefore 3 inch is equal to 7.62 cm. This is the calculation. Now similarly, observe the second problem. Second problem, a jug containing 2 liters of milk. A jug containing 2 liters of milk. Calculate the volume of milk in meter cube. Calculate the volume in meter cube. Meter cube bali na ondu jug na 2 liter milk na calculate madbeku. Now the volume is calculated in meter cube or centimeter cube or mm. You know the volume will be calculated or measured in the form of milliliters, ml, or centimeter cube, or meter cube. This is the three units we are using to measure the volume. So, nodibodo, daribodada, 2 liters ml, 2 liters milk, that we also called as 2000 ml, 2000 ml, or that is also called as 2000 centimeter cube. And it is also called as how much of meter cube. So now we have to calculate the meter cube volume of 2 liters in meter cube. Meter cube. Now to calculate, observe, we know that 1 liter, here there is given 2 liters, we know that 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter, 1000 ml, or that is equal to 1000 centimeter cube, 1000 centimeter cube. Okay, therefore 2 liter is equal to how much? 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml, therefore 2 liters is equal to 2000 ml, 2000 milliliter, that is equal to how much? 2000 centimeter. Okay, then you know centi means how much? You know in SI units we are writing centimeter cube. Centi is nothing but how much? Centi is nothing but 10^-2. You know centi is nothing but 10^-2, therefore write into centimeters, that is in meter cube. This can be written like, that is 2000 centimeter cube is equal to 2000 into 10^-2 meter cube, like that. Okay, observe, this can be written here 2000, therefore 2000 centimeter cube is equal to 2000 into 10^-2 meter cube, like that. Okay, we are writing that one. C is nothing but how much? 10^-2. Now 3 2s are 6, this can be written like that. So observe, 2000 into 10^-2 meter whole cube, that can be written like that. That is 2000 into 10^-6, 3 2s are 6, and meter cube. Now we have to calculate volume in meter cube. Now cancel this one. It is equal to 2000 into 10 power minus 6 is nothing but 10 power minus 3 into 10 power minus 3. And this 2000 can be written as 2 into 10 power 3. So that can be written as what? Into meter cube. Now this can be written as 2 into 10 power 3. Okay? Into 10 power minus 3. Into 10 power minus 3 into meter cube. Now 10 power minus 3, 10 power plus 3 get cancelled. So what you get finally? 2 into 10 power minus 3 meter cube. This is the wall, that is 2 liters. Therefore, 2 liters is equal to how much? 2 into 10 power minus 3 meter cube. Okay? This is the final answer. Now, take third problem. So listen, the third problem is given, how many seconds are there in 2 days? How many seconds are there in 2 days? This is the third problem. Now to calculate this one, you should know some basic seconds, minutes conversion or hours conversions. So observe, we have to calculate number of seconds in 2 days. Number of seconds in 2 days. So you know 1 minute is equal to 1 minute is equal to how many seconds? 60 seconds. 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Then similarly, 1 hour is equal to 1 hour is equal to how many minutes? 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Okay? That you know. Basically. Then similarly, 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour. And 24 hours is equal to how many days? How many hours per day? 24 hours. Therefore, 24 hours is equal to how many days? 1 day. Okay? And similarly, here we have to go into calculate 2 days to seconds. Now, therefore, 48 hours. 48 hours is equal to how many days? 2 days. Okay? Clarify. Now observe, 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Therefore, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. And 24 hours is equal to 1 day. Therefore, 48 hours is equal to 2 days. 2 days. Now, first calculate for hour how many seconds. For hours, how many seconds you should calculate? After calculating that, then calculate for 48 hours how many seconds. Then you get for 2 days how many seconds. So 2 days is equal to nothing but 48 hours. And 48 hours is equal to how many seconds? You should calculate like that. Now observe the answer. So first you calculate for 1 hour how many seconds. So here observe, you know 1 minute is equal to how many seconds? 60 seconds. Therefore, for 1 hour, how many seconds? Calculate for 1 hour how many seconds? We don't know. Here there I am written in minutes. So calculate in seconds. Now to calculate seconds, do cross multiplication. After doing cross multiplication, what you get? 1 hour into 60 minutes, that is question mark is equal to. This question mark is nothing but hours. That is equal to 60 seconds into 1 hour whole divided by 1 minute. 60 seconds is equal to 1 hour. Or, right, calculate for 60 minutes. 60 minutes, yeah. Don't take hour, take 60 minutes. For 60 minutes, how many hours? Sorry, how many minutes? How many minutes? Therefore, 60 seconds into 60 minutes. 60 seconds into 60 minutes. 60 minutes divided by 1 minute. Okay, got it? Now we have to calculate seconds per 60 minutes. 60 minutes. 60 minutes is nothing but 1 hour. Either you take 1 hour or 60 minutes. Just to avoid the confusion, we are taking 60 minutes rather than 1 hour. Now, 60 seconds into 60 minutes. 60 60 seconds is 60 minutes divided by 1 minute. So minutes get the answer that is equal to 60 into 60. That is 66 are 36 and there is 2 zeros put 2 zeros. These are the seconds. Seconds, minutes get the answer, you get seconds. For how many minutes? This is for 60 minutes. For 60 minutes, how many seconds? 3600 seconds. That is equal to how many hours? 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour. Now you get for 1 hour, 60 minutes, that is equal to 3600 seconds. Now calculate for 48 hours. You know, 1 hour is equal to how much? Therefore, this can be written in what? 1 hour is equal to, this can be written as 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. Okay. Now, for 48 hours is equal to days, right? Therefore, 48 hours is equal to how many seconds? Seconds. Okay. Now do cross multiplication again. 48 into, that is question mark, is equal to 48 hours into 3600 seconds whole divided by 1 hour. So hour get the answer, you get seconds. Seconds. Now multiply 48 into 3600. Multiply this one, 48 into 3600. How much you get? 1,72,800. 1,72,800.